yourself
on the SAT.
Sell on your feet. On your feet. Let's get it. Let's on. Get it on. Lift yourself up
on the SAT.
Sell on your feet.
On your feet.
Let's get it.
Let's
on.
Get it on.
In order to get started with being our Kanye Best, we are going to need to log in to two places. The first is Khan Academy. We get into Khan Academy by going to either Safari or Google Chrome and going to satpractice.org. We've already set up your Khan Academy account, so when we get there, we're going to hit the login in the upper right. And this step is very important. We need to hit the continue with Google. If we just put in the email and the password without first hitting continue with Google, it's going to say that we don't have an account, but we do. So we need to hit the red continue with Google and then sign in with your school account information. Once we're logged in, we might see ourselves at this screen where we'll hit start practicing. That will bring us here where we need to either select whether we want to focus on practicing math or reading and writing. All sophomores will be starting by practicing with math. So I'll select math over on the right-hand side. Up at the top, you'll see there is a section that indicates your recommendations. This your recommendations section is based off of my results on the PSAT. So it is looking at the three areas where I struggled the most on the PSAT, and therefore the three areas that I most need to improve upon in order to be successful on the SAT. So we can see for this student that I need to focus on linear and quadratic systems, units, and solving linear equations and linear inequalities. Then I'll conclude with a timed mini section. So this section of your recommendations is what we call your pathway. This is very important in the Kanye Best game. I'm going to transition us here for a second to Schoology. Each of you have been added to a course called Kanye Best 2022, and you'll look for an orange icon with Kanye's face on it. Once we get in here, we're going to select Math Round 1, and we're going to go ahead and download that attachment, which is the Kanye Best score sheet. You'll notice that the first thing that I need on this Kanye Best score sheet is a screenshot of your pathway. That is exactly what we were just talking about over in Khan Academy. So I'm going to turn myself sideways here, and I'm going to take a screenshot of my pathway, which again is the three areas that Khan Academy says I need to practice based off of my performance on the PSAT. So I've got my screenshot. Now I'm going to hop back to Notability, and I'm going to insert my screenshot. I can crop this a bit to make it focus just so we're looking at the pathway, nothing extra. And I'll place this up at the top where I said I needed my pathway. Now the reason we need the pathway is it shows us, like I said, the three skills that we need to focus on, and those correspond to the rest of the score sheet where we'll see skill 1, skill 2, and skill 3. So once again, skill 1 for this student is going to be linear and quadratic systems, skill 2 is units, and skill 3 is solving linear equations and linear inequalities. So the first thing I need to practice is the first thing listed on my pathway. So linear and quadratic systems, I'll hit start task.
But wait, I don't know how to do this problem. I need some instruction first.
I'm gonna have to scroll down to the bottom and find where that practice is and watch some videos, some how-to examples of how to solve those problems over here on the right. It can be a little overwhelming to scroll through all of these things and find what I'm supposed to be practicing on. So if you're struggling to find linear and quadratic systems, for example, You can go up to the top where you're at khanacademy.org, and you can type in linear. If I scroll through, you'll notice that there is a section that indicates on this page. If I hit that, it's going to highlight every time the word linear appears on this page, and I'll have some arrows over here on the left that'll hop me through. So I'm looking for a linear and quadratic, and here it is. So now I've been easily able to find my linear and quadratic systems, and I can come over here. I'll look at a basic example first of someone showing me how to do it, and then I can hop back, look at a harder example before I even have to start my practice. So I can teach myself before I start my practice. Each time you get a result at the end of a practice, you're gonna screenshot your results and you're going to insert those into your score sheet.
Let's take a look together at an example of a beautifully completed Kanye Best score sheet. For this student, it says that the first thing she needs to practice is linear function word problems. Then when she's proficient on that, she needs to move to linear inequality word problems. Then once she's finished with that, she needs to practice linear equation word problems. And lastly, she'll need to do the timed mini section. So, as I said, the first thing that she needed to practice was linear function word problems. So then when I scroll down to the skill number one section of her score sheet, I can see that she is practicing linear function word problems. And the first time she practiced it, she got a 3 out of 5, which is a 60%. Now to move on from skill one to skill two, she would need to be at least an 80%. So that means that she needs to go back and do linear function word problems again. So on her second attempt, she got a 5 out of 5, so she was proficient on linear function word problems, which means that she's ready to move on to linear inequality word problems. So skill number two, sure enough, she's working on linear inequality word problems. And the first time again, she got a 3 out of 5, so she needed to go back to the list of skills, find where that is listed, click on it, and then continue with her practice. And the second time she got a 100. She continues working on this score sheet until she is proficient in her third skill, and then she completes her timed mini section. So for this student, she was proficient either on her second attempt or her first attempt. But some of these practices are really hard, and it's gonna take you a while for some of these until you're proficient. Maybe it takes you 8 times to practice on one skill until you're proficient. That is perfectly okay. This is hard, and we get better by practicing and trying things again and again. That is how we learn. Now let's imagine that that happens to you, where it takes you 8 times to become proficient on a skill. So for you, you would put the screenshot of your first attempt, your second attempt, your third attempt, and then where it says last, you would put your screenshot of attempt number 8. So you don't need to provide me with your screenshots of all 8 attempts. I would just need to see your first 3, and then whenever you become proficient. If that's attempt number 4, great. If that's attempt number 8, great. If that's attempt number 20, great. I just want to see that you are continuing to chip away and become proficient at these skills. So please don't get frustrated if you're still practicing on that first skill. That is okay. That is how we become better at things. Now, when it comes to your timed mini section, all I need to see there is that you made an attempt. So your timed mini section doesn't always correspond to what your pathway had you practicing. So for this student, she only got a 1 out of 10 on her timed mini section. Maybe the timed mini section was asking her to do things that she hadn't yet had a chance to practice prior to that. That's okay. I just need to see that you have made an attempt at your timed mini section. And that is how you complete a Kanye Best score sheet. Now let's talk about submitting your Kanye Best score sheet. You're going to be submitting it to two different Schoology courses. One is the Kanye Best 2022 Schoology course, and that's where you submit for the game and winning prizes, which is what we were just talking about. You'll also submit it, though, to your SAT Prep Schoology course, and this is where you submit it to earn a grade. So let's talk a little bit about how you earn a grade for each time you complete Khan Academy. Here is the rubric that we'll use to grade your daily Khan Academy, and as you can see, there's two ways to get a 100. The first way is to make two different attempts and show growth between the attempts. The second way is to get proficient or an 80% on your first try. So here is an example of the first type. So here we have someone who was working on their pathway, and the first time they got 2 out of 11 questions correct, and then they did it again and they got a 3 out of 11 questions correct. So they grew from their first attempt to their second attempt, they got better at it, and therefore they scored a 100. So this is the example of I made 2 attempts, growing, and made a 100. The other example is you got a proficient on your first attempt. So here the student got a 10 out of 11 the first time, which is over an 80%, so they got a 100 for their first attempt.
On the SAT.